Hey guys, Insomni here with some more AFK Arena. Today we're back on the Lightbearer account and we are looking at Ainz and Albedo. So as we know, today will be the redemption period. We have, starting in 10 hours, 47 minutes here, the redemption for Ainz or Albedo. So the question really is, who should you get? So remember, when we're looking at the redemption, you can actually redeem whatever you have here. Most players are going to be short on hero coins, which is most frequently what we see. But remember, when the redemption period starts, you are going to have a total of 7 days, essentially, once you do the redemption. So once I do the redemption, as you can see, I'm a little bit short on the hero coins. I'm not going to have another 40,000 hero coins to go ahead and build this up. So to supplement the hero coins that I am going to be missing, which I will be completely maxed on the guild coins, Labyrinth tokens, as you can see, I'll be completely maxed. Same with the Legends Challenger Tournament tokens, I will be completely maxed as well. Meaning that we are going to need more Labyrinth coins. So over the next couple days, not only did Lilith allow us to do the Labyrinth of Limbo, which is going to double your token drops, you can make sure to stock this up. But at this point as well, you should also have your mailbox full, which I am just waiting for the redemption period at this point to collect all of these. So essentially redeeming it for one of the heroes, collecting all of my loot here, running the labyrinth to compensate for the guild coins that I'm not going to have, or the hero coins that I am not going to have. But the question really becomes, do you pick Ainz? Do you pick Albedo? So honestly, it is your own choice at this point. Looking at both heroes, make sure you choose the one that most prefers your game style, because they do bring very, very unique things to AFK Arena. So looking here at Albedo, of course, her signature item is really the Reliant one. So during battle, the defense rating of all dimensional heroes are increased by 15% for every dimensional hero that is in the allied formation. That can stack 2 times. This is an absolute crazy amount of defense, especially because it can be stacked. Now, looking towards the future, we know Persona 5 is doing a crossover event, which is going to bring us more dimensional heroes. This could come into play when it comes a lot more towards endgame because of the defense rating increase. Also, if you look at the plus 10, during battle, the defense of all dimensional heroes are increased by 25% for every dimensional. Plus 20 gives you 3 times. So a 25% defense for every dimensional that is in there. Do not overlook the power that Albedo brings. The plus 30, very, very strong as well. During battle, the attack rating of all dimensional heroes are increased by 15% for every dimensional hero in the formation. The effects of this ability can stack 3 times. So essentially, if you're running 3-dimensional heroes, you are going to get the 25% defense rating increase for every dimensional hero. You are going to get a 15% attack rating increase for every dimensional hero, up to 3 for both of them, which is an insane amount of stats that she is going to bring just from her signature item alone. Not only the hero herself, very, very defensive. They do need to make a couple adjustments to her. So one of the big things is with her Shield Lord, her stun. So a couple of her abilities can be blocked, can be nullified with shields, can be dodged, which is very, very difficult because essentially if she's doing an attack and the heroes just dodge the attack, the stun doesn't take place for her Shield Lord ability, which is very, very tough. But remember, if she's run with Ainz Al Ghul, she does prioritize him over everything. So a couple of her other abilities though, Blackguard, very, very strong defensive mechanism. When the shield exists, neither Albedo or the ally she is protected can be controlled by enemies. So she is giving immunity to crowd control as well as shields to increase her survivability. Also with her this ability, not even gonna try to pronounce it, crit resistance is increased by 35 points. If she is dealt a critical strike, the attacker's attack rating is reduced by 30%. And as you can see in the level 3, the attacker's reduction in attack rating is reduced by 50%. So again, her being a tank hero, very, very powerful, especially with her signature item. So not just looking at what she brings, but looking at what she really brings with defense and attack when it comes to the dimensional formation. So essentially though, with her is if you do not have dimensionals in the formation. So if you're running Albedo by herself, she is just gonna offer the buff to herself and nobody else, which means she is meant and built to run with other dimensional heroes in by herself. So looking here at the furniture, of course, three-piece is kind of required for Albedo. She enters a rage with slash 10 seconds whenever Al Ghul dies or whenever the first ally except Ainz on her team dies. So she is going to go into a rage. During the enraged state, she is immune to crowd control and damage. Remember, immune to damage for 10 seconds, a very, very powerful attribute that she is going to gain. And 250% of her defense rating is converted into her attack rating. So now we think of the signature item, the 25% bonus if you're running three dimensionals, the attack bonus if you're running three dimensionals. Now 250% of the defense rating is converted into attack, making her very, very powerful because of that attack rating boost. If she is using her Blackguard ability to protect an ally, the enraged state shall be initiated once her Blackguard ability ends. Very, very good, because you're not going to burn through the timer, the 10-second timer, guarding another hero in the back. Then, of course, 80% of the damage caused during the enraged state is converted into Albedo's health, meaning she has her own heal when you have her 9-piece bonus, which is, again, very, very strong. One of the drawbacks to this is it only works once. So she enters a rage which lasts 10 seconds when Ainz dies or the first ally on her team dies. It is only going to be a one-use time. Once it is done, it will be completely done, but makes her very, very powerful with the 3-set bonus for furniture. So the other hero we look at is, of course, Ainz. Ainz is the magic caster. He does a absolute crazy amount of damage with his ultimate ability, falling down chant, which lasts 5 seconds. The cooldown on this is very, very big. 5 seconds to cast the ult, similar to Sophia's Falling Sun ability, but does a lot of damage. For Ainz to really be effective, you do have to have his signature item, and you do have to have it quite a bit higher, because the signature item will get rid of the chanting phase. So you're getting rid of those 5 seconds that you need. So chanting phase of the ultimate ability Falling Down is emitted the first time. Plus 10 omits it 2 times, plus 20 omits it 3 times. Then the ultimate ability Falling Down deals an extra 30% damage. His plus 30 signature item definitely needs to be built on Ainz. 30% damage to an ultimate ability. Not only that, is 3 times, the first 3 times he casts it, you do not have to do the chant. So it's not gonna have that 5 second cooldown time as well when he's doing the chant. He will just go ahead and ult when he is full. Very, very powerful. Also, the goal of life is death. This is another ability that is very strong. After 24 seconds of battle, all enemies lose 50% of their current health and are stunned. Very, very powerful, which is exacerbated by the furniture. 9-piece furniture, the effect of the ability, the goal of life is death, will take effect after 15 seconds of battle. So you get 15 seconds in, he is going to half everyone's hit points and stun them for 4 seconds. Very, very powerful ability. Magic caster cycles through 3 normal attacks, which is strengthened yet again by his furniture. So every 8 seconds during battle, the damage and debuff duration of the magic caster abilities are increased by 200%. So not only the damage, but the duration is going to be increased when it comes to the magic caster ability, making him do more damage the longer he's up. So not only the ultimate ability doing damage, he does have the goal of all life is death, halving the hit points and providing a stun, as well as the magic caster doing quite a bit of damage and locking out heroes from their ultimate ability, which brings us to steady preparation. At the beginning of battle, he receives a shield. This was actually adjusted to read the next part, While the shield exists, Ainz is immune to enemy control abilities and continues to chant, gaining 70 energy points, plus 4% attack rating, plus 8% defense rating, attributes per second for 6 seconds. Once the shield disappears, Ainz ceases chanting. So before, Nara could counter it, Athalia could counter it, a lot of counters to this, but now he is immune to enemy control, which makes it very, very powerful. The level 2 attack rating is increased by 6% per second, defense by 10% per second. Once Ainz's attributes have increased 6 times, he will receive an additional 50 crit amplification and 30 attack speed points. So he does his own crit, he does his own attack. Very, very powerful caster. Coupled that, of course, with Albedo bringing an additional defense to him, bringing additional attack rating to him. Very, very hard to choose which hero to build if you only have to build one. Like I said, the choice is ultimately yours when it comes to these heroes. Ainz, very powerful hero, especially works in a lot of different formations, just massive, massive damage. One of the big things to remember, though, is we do not know the future of AFK Arena, what the dimensional heroes are going to look like, and seeing exactly what Albedo is going to bring as far as her signature item with the defense, with the attack rating, two formations, and what it is going to look like. So again, those are the dimensional heroes. We're going to be able to redeem them very, very soon. If you did buy Arthur tokens, which I know a lot of people had talked about, you can actually sell them back just in case you need those little shards. I know it is a little bit cheaper or a little bit discounted from what you bought them from, but you can sell them back to get some more lab tokens to make sure you complete that. So guys, new event coming very, very soon. Ainz and Albedo will be here today. Got about 10 more hours to the redemption period, and then everything is just going to be blowing up from people getting Ainz and Albedo. Make sure you go through, make sure you make a very, very educated decision on the hero you're going to look for. Most players have said they're going for Ainz for the caster ability, but do not overlook Albedo just because of what she brings to dimensionals. So you also do have to look at Arthur, you know, looking at Nakaruru, looking at Ezio. Albedo is going to bring a massive, massive debuff or a massive defensive buff to these heroes, as well as a significant increase to their attack power, which could make a big difference in the future, especially when we're starting to get more dimensional heroes like the Persona 5 crossover, Prince of Persia, if it comes. Going to be interesting to see exactly what is going to happen in the future. Ainz, even though he's very, very powerful, might be backseated by some of the new heroes that we get, some of the new damage dealers, which can be further kind of looked at with the power that Albedo will bring to a team comp. Also, we do know AFK Arena or Lilith loves to rework heroes, so all it takes is one little rework or some adjustments to Albedo, and she will be absolutely amazing like she is right now. Very, very powerful hero. So guys, let me know in the comments what you guys think. And as always, thank you guys for watching.